this video presents about thin film deposition in nanotechnology. So over the thin film deposition, a thin film is a layer of material ranging from fractions of nanometer, that is monolayer, to several micrometers in thickness. So the thin film deposition has been formed in micrometer technology itself. It is adapted with nanotechnology also. The thin film technology is a self-organizing structural evolution whenever it comes across nanomaterials. Example, in ancient times, people already knew how to beat gold into thin film, which is less than 1 micrometer thickness, with the hammers itself, and knew how to use this gold leaf for coating all kinds of stuffs. So in the ancient times itself, they have used nanomaterials using just the hammer. So the need for thin film development has been arisen nowadays because to maintain some surface uniformity, to reduce the amount or mass of light absorbing material, to spray coating technology for superior functional medical coating, to decrease the weight and bulkiness of the materials. Because whenever you go with nanotechnology, the material will be very small, but the covering material takes up so much mass over it. So to reduce that bulkiness, they go for thin film development using nanotechs. So now we will see in detail about thin film technology. Thin film technology involves deposition of individual molecules or atoms, uniform ultra-thin film coating onto stents, catheters, balloons, endoscopic instruments, pacemakers, heart valves, glucose monitors, sensors, medical textiles, blood collection tubes, surgical implants, orthopedic implants and diagnostic devices have been noted. So the thin film technology is mostly used in medical applications, and so here the uniform ultra-thin film coating on medical applications have been highlighted, but it is used in various industries also. So the example for industrial thin films produced are amorphous silica and cadmium telluride. These are used as thin film layers for nanomaterials. Then the physical properties of this thin film depositions are film thickness, roughness. So over the film thickness, the physical property of a thin film are highly dependent on thickness. Thickness measurement methods are applied during deposition itself, and the methods by which thickness can be determined after finishing a coating run exterior is by gravimetric method or optical methods. Gravimetric, you know how the gravitation exerts on any material. And optical method, based on the absorption, we can find the thickness of the thin layers. And the next physical property is roughness. In ultra-thin films, it can influence all film properties such as mechanical, electrical, magnetical or electrical optical properties. So the roughness types, the mechanism of their origin, roughness measurement and roughness quantification needs to be taken into consideration, because as these are nanoparticles, the coating has to serve the purpose. So coating is to make the material to be safer or to react in particular manner. So that has to be done with the roughness of the outer layer itself. And so we have to consider it very carefully. Then the next is chemical properties. So conventional methods of chemical analysis such as atomic emission, atomic absorption, spectral analysis, X-ray fluorescence and mass spectroscopy play an important role for the production of coating materials. So see, atomic emission and absorption, their X-ray fluorescence over the thin layers, and mass spectroscopy are playing important role. And over the chemical properties, we have to take care of the interaction of photons, electrons, ions or other particles with the coating or surface. So those also has to be analyzed for perfectly analyzing the chemical properties. and over this different deposition techniques has been used, which is done to controllably transfer atoms from a source to the substrate. Because over the substrate only we have to make this thin layer deposition, as we have seen with the lithography techniques. So the deposition techniques are evaporative methods, glow discharge technologies, gas phase chemical processes, and liquid phase chemical formation. So these are the four methods for under deposition techniques. So over chemical vapor deposition, as we have already seen, chemicals has been introduced and they have made to react and made the nanoparticle to evaporate and sediment over a substrate layer to get the nano material whatever we desire. So here gaseous compounds are made to react to form a dense layer of heated substrate. The most widely deposited wear resistant coatings are tin carbide and tin nitride, chromium carbide and alumina. The deposition temperatures are generally in the range of 800 to 1000 degrees Celsius, and so specialized furnace has been used for this. The thickness are limited to about 10 micrometer due to thermal expansion mismatch stresses which develop on cooling, which also resists the coating of sharp edge components. The limitation is with 10 micrometer because it is just deposited. We can't control the thickness. So it is allowed to deposit over the substrate. So it comes over 10 micrometer thickness because we have to take out these coatings. So there is no control over it. This is the limitation. And the advantages of chemical vapor deposition is high coating hardness, good adhesion. If the coating is not too thick, good adhesion will be there. Good throwing power, that is uniformity of coating. So throwing power only deposits, good throwing power means deposition over the surface by falling over there. So because of it, uniformity of coating is achieved. The disadvantages are high temperature process, which cause sometimes distortions. Sharp edge coating is difficult as these are depositing over the layer. So heat it reacted and made to evaporate and sediment over there. And so thermal expansion mismatch stresses will be there. Because of thermal expansion, mismatches may occur, which causes stresses over the material. So limited range of materials can be coated based on the furnace or the chamber what we are using, the size of the chamber. And environmental concerns about process gases has to be taken care of because we have to make a vacuum over there, and over the vacuum only these gases compounds are made to react to form the dense layers. So these are the advantages and disadvantages whenever we apply with the chemical vapor deposition. And then physical vapor deposition, low power coating processes in which the coating flux is produced by a physical process. There are two main types, evaporation and sputtering. You know what is evaporation, what is sputtering. In both cases, the source material is a solid, either metal or ceramic. A reactive gas may be used in the deposition chamber to deposit compound coatings from an elemental source or maintain the stoichiometry of coating from compound sources. Though thinner layers are used in microelectronics and the thicker layers are used for high temperature. So here evaporation means high temperature has been given and they are made to evaporate. And in the previous case, chemical compounds has been used. Here the source material is a solid, either metal or ceramic. Over that you have to give a reactive gas deposited over the chamber and it is made to get the heat. So if you are using thinner layer means microelectronics has been used, thicker layers means high temperature will be used. High temperature, thicker layers used, with microelectronics thinner layers used. And sputtering also, it's just throwing out. So the advantages are it's having excellent process control as these are physical vapor depositions. So based on the metal and the microelectronic or high temperature availability, we can control the process. So low deposition temperature is only there. Here dense and adherent coatings are here because of we are having the control over the temperature, and so we can do everything. The elemental, alloy and the compound coatings are possible. And the disadvantages are vacuum processes with a high capital cost, limited component size treatable, relatively low coating rates, poor throwing power without manipulation of components. So here, as there is no vigorous chemical reactions occurring, just a reactive gas over the solid, so poor throwing power will be there. Coating rate also very less because no higher reaction will be there. Just physical processing is there. And so it's having low coating rate. So these are the things with the physical vapor deposition. Next to that, ultrasonic nozzle technology. So in the low velocity, soft spray with minimal overspray saves up to 80% in coating material. Here low velocity and soft spraying has been applied. And independent control of process parameters including flow rate, spray velocity, drop size and depositions will be there. Because as it is ultrasonics, we can increase and decrease the intensity, and nozzle is also there in addition, so we can control everything. Precise control over a wide range of flow rates is also possible. Non-clogging, repeatable performance as ultrasonic waves is there. Clogging effect is not there. And as we are having nozzle, we can control and repeat the process. And the choice of drop size depends on the nozzle what we are using. The frequency of drop size ranges from 18 to 49 microns. Deagglomeration of particles in suspension due is also there. So it can be made to a gel and again liquid or crystal shape will be attained using this process controls using ultrasonic waves. So this is the next technology. And these technologies has been applied to form thin films, and it requires simple fabrication steps. It requires low fabrication temperature of up to 300 degrees Celsius itself. Manufacturing requires little materials, that is thin cell to crystalline thin cells with a crystalline thickness of 1 to 300 microns. These are flexible and non-breakable, very strong. High voltage can be obtained. No infrastructure needed to support cells. Cell can double as building material whenever it is used as roofing tiles, walls, etc. to get higher reactivity and vibration effects over the walls. So the thin films having so many applications in electronics field also. In electronics field, mechanical field, and in chemical reactors, these thin films find so many applications. These are the advantages. And this thin film is having so many applications in addition to its easy processings. Thank you.